Greetings, everybody, and happy carnival. I see everybody is already enjoying the festivities. So for those of you who aren't familiar with carnival or what it is, it's basically the beginning of Lent. And I gather that it's celebrated differently in different parts of the world. And I myself am not Catholic, so I can't really speak to it from any direct experience, other than the fact that things tend to get really crazy here in Germany, depending on what part of the country you're in, when carnival starts. I see that there are a number of Germans already in chat who have been explaining this. And I guess maybe I might as well just start. Doride, Mubot will no longer ban people for links, so you can go ahead and post whatever links you feel are necessary. Please just use good judgment and be civil with links, though, because if people start posting porn or linking to unscrupulous things, then Mubot will have to come back. You are correct, Filey, in so much as Mubot will not bother people for links. He is not really on the bench, though. He's still hanging around, but he's now only instructed to ban people for truly serious things. Ovon, if I had a nickel for every time somebody has said that to me, I'd have maybe 10 or 15 cents right now. I see I should not have brought up porn. In any case, hello everybody. Welcome. I see many familiar names, a few unfamiliar names. I see my head mod, Filey. Welcome to all. I'm all right, thanks, Zenpok. I'm fairly tired. I had kind of a long night last night. While we're talking about real sex. No, actually. I was up very late last night working on the game text for Salt and Sanctuary. And I feel kind of badly about being here now doing this, because the text for Salt and Sanctuary is due fairly soon. And part of me really wants to be working on that and finishing it up, but I also picked a really stupid time to submit my application for a Twitch partnership, and I have to get in at least a couple of good broadcasts in the application period. So I sort of bit off a little bit more than I could chew. Deride, yes. Yes, indeed, I do have some tea. And as a matter of fact, now that you remind me, I should pour myself a cup, and I should probably get going here as well. Let's see here. Oh, geez. hang on a minute. Oh, dear. Let's see. Malkavian Madness. Malkavian Madness, thank you. thank you so much for the $5 donation. Malkavian Madness says, "Heyo, my favorite of all the internet peoples." Ah, thank you, Malkavian Madness. I really appreciate that. That's very kind of you. All right, now it appears there is... here's some form of problem with the capture. Let me try and resolve that now. Silent J Pyramid Head, welcome. There we go. Okay, I just had to switch inputs. Fantastic. P3 Fez or P4G, the Sungro Solaire? I would play P3 first because P4 is a direct sequel, and a lot of the stuff in P4 will make quite a bit more sense once you've cleared P3 and you're already familiar with the concepts introduced there. Also, now that we're in-game and everyone can maybe give me a better idea of this, how is the audio balance? Is the commentary audible over the game? Is the game not too loud? How is this sounding to everyone? No problem, Filey. Most important thing is for you to pass exams, so don't worry about lurking a little bit. I think between you, me, and Moobot, and any other mods who show up, we'll probably be fine. Glad to hear it, Kurosa's area. Thank you, and everybody. Ervile, don't even. Shiluf, it depends on your priorities. If you want to succeed at life, I recommend you go study for your psychology exam. Now, who am I kidding? Psychology won't get you anywhere in life. You might as well just stay here. Ask Pat. He'll tell you how useful his psychology degree was. Okay, Shiluf. Well, you're welcome here for as long as you care to stay. Alright, so let me try and get my bearings here, because I don't remember quite where we left off. This is June 1st. And... okay. Where are we at for social links? Okay. Thanks to my training, I really stood out during the scrimmage. The young mother whom I'm boning while her husband is away on business. The drama club waifu who's always overacting. Adachi seems to have an old lady following him around. That I don't even need to embellish. Okay. Alright, I think I remember. The Sungro Solaire, it's alright. I imagine you're just joining us midway through, so yes, I intend to finish this game on Twitch. This has been requested by my viewers quite a lot, and, well, it gives me something to play on Twitch. Shiloof, I think you'd probably like these games if you're into old school JRPGs, especially story driven ones. No, Dorai, this is actually my first recording since we had that hour and a half conversation about food at the end of the last broadcast. Ninja OFV, I don't think so. Pretty much everything after Dojima was just us sitting around talking about our favorite foods while I did nothing in the game. So, much like now, actually. Eviscerator, welcome! Nice to see you back here as well. Alright, so I don't remember if... No, nothing in the fridge. Okay, I think we just picked up an origami book, didn't we? So let's read that. Easy origami, because I think this is going to help us with the origami job. The origami job. That sounds like, God. The fox was the origami killer. You read on, hoping that this will help you to learn different ways of folding origami. There are still some pages of easy origami left. Kaito, hey, welcome! Fair enough, Filey. And who is... Moril, hey, welcome! Thank you for dropping in, Moril. Yeah, the artist, I know, but it was obligatory. I had to. Okay. Now for some actual tea. Because I was busy fixing broadcasting problems before. I guess we're still waiting for Kanji to recover, then. And no music? Oh, right, because it's raining, I forgot. There's no music when it rains. Let's see here. Alright. Got tea, got mods, got viewers. I think we're good to go. Ah, that's right, Kaito. Happy Chinese New Year to you as well. Thank you. I'm not sure, Doride. I think we still have to... There are still a few things we have to accomplish. Alright, so I think... What social links do I want to work on today? I think we'll go with Sun and Justice. So I've got Sun... And I've got Justice. Fantastic! Alright, so off to drama club we go. Oh, and it seems...
Hey!
She's already here. But first... Before we do that... Oh, she chastised me. Oh, that's terrible. Alright. Let's see what creepy items we can find. Yellow Dio Mike, there's actually a command that you can use in chat. I'll show it to you there. And Mubot will tell you, if I have any particular kind of tea during a given broadcast, then Mubot will let you know what it is. And this particular kind of tea, I really, really love, but it's extremely hard to get because apparently they only ordered a small amount of it. And I'm told that they're already out.
Hey!
All right. We might get along well. Yeah, let's go to Drama Club.
Okay.
After she chastises me. God, Furkan Tule, appearance-wise... I don't know, I feel like it's kind of a cop-out to say Lucifer. Because he was the final boss, well, one of the final bosses, potentially, depending on what story path you take, in an earlier Atlas game, but I don't know. He's just such a badass persona. Oban 20, not really all that much. You can get a tin of good quality tea even from a more high-end and sort of pricey purveyor like Harney and Sons, which is the only brand I'm familiar with, so I can't really speak to other brands, but you can get a tin of tea from them for $4, $5, $6 US, and it'll still be perfectly good quality tea. Even probably better than you'd get elsewhere. We thoroughly practiced expressing a variety of emotions, and as a result, our expression increased. Drama Club's going to be in the school concours? Or concours? Not sure. Those French words. I'm going to have the lead role this year. Well, I guess the outcome was never really in doubt. Help you with your part later, sure. What? Non-drama club member. God, I love how these students are identified. Great, so now we've got some real drama.
Huh?
Just what I needed. Well... Mayo, it's no problem. I don't hate people who drink coffee. Quickly explain Persona to you, Keycaps. I'm just going to borrow Pat's words. Persona games are weeaboo simulators, but basically just really good weeaboo simulators. Well, I guess we're just throwing in the towel for today, then. Because Drama Club can't handle real drama. I decided to follow her to the hospital, because that's not creepy. Hot chocolate, Filey. Nice change of pace, huh? Oh, she hates her dad. That's right. Kids, if you hate your dad, don't forget to tell him you hate him, and that you're not crying, and that you need food, and that you're tired. Bob Austin, I'm guessing you're someplace like Texas or Hawaii. Yeah, you and me both, Phyle. Though I don't like alcohol at all, so I'm pretty much on the run anytime somebody offers me a drink. Yeah, Mayo, having parents is a bad idea. Nobody should have parents. Clint, that analogy of beer, it's like drinking a loaf of bread, only with more incinerated, charred, burnt flavor. You know, Clint, I'm really glad to know that I'm not missing anything. The weirdest state? What state is that, Bob Austin? Epicinium? I don't know if we're going with Latin pronunciations here, but, what's going on with Yumi is essentially that her father is kind of a bastard, and she hates him. And her mother is sort of taking the weak road and capitulating anyway. This is actually, to be fair, as much as I dislike both Sun social links in Persona 4 Golden, Yumi's is probably one of the more divisive, because you could make arguments for both sides. Phyle, you give yourself too little credit. Ervile, you just haven't had good tea. You've probably only had that crap Lipton makes, in which case, yeah, I don't blame you, because that stuff is like sucking on grass. Chimera Elite, hello! All is more or less alright. I'm kinda tired. Had a long night last night, but I'm waking up now that all of you are here. Now that Yumi has just completely lambasted her mother for being weak. Yumi should just end her father in Mortal Kombat. Cause that's what we need in a Persona game, is a Mortal Kombat sequence. Oh no, she finally noticed that I've been standing here the whole time. Well, she's gonna hate me either way, so... Oh, I'm so sick. Such a terrible thing you didn't say something to me before. Ovon20, maybe when Hulkamania is involved, yes. I've been wanting to highlight that mid-boss fight from the previous stream, but I just can't bring myself to go back and dig through, what was it, 8 hours worth of footage to try and find that again. Oh, how could I? Oh, it's so terrible. Oh, I might as well confide in you, since you're here, and it's convenient. Thanks, Japan. So, this is what I mean about Yumi's mother being weak. Her dad was a dirtbag, cheated on her mom, abandoned them, and now her mom is coming back on her hands and knees. And the girl that he cheated with dumped him, so... yeah, I don't care how this social link plays out. Yumi has some pretty damn good reasons for being upset. Take your time, Tsuyokomi. Yeah, doesn't he, Black Ops Legend? Yes, Ams the Great. What's on your mind? Oh, thank you for reminding me, Ams the Great. Actually, I should probably send another tweet to let everybody know that we're live. I always forget to do that. I always mean to. And I always forget. I almost just tweeted the URL of this tea that I have today instead of a link to Twitter or to Twitch. Thank you, Ams the Great, for reminding me about that. All right. Oh, yeah, no, I see what you mean, Ams the Great. And yeah, I'm not sure when our next opportunity for combat is even going to be. Because that's going to be rescuing Naoto, and I don't think that's for a little while yet. Yellow Dio Mike, those guys tend to be incredibly busy, and their free time to be dicking around with guys like me is pretty much non-existent. That Demon Souls stream I did with them this past weekend, that was arranged well in advance. They set aside the time for that long ago, and I took the following Monday off work so that I could be available for it. So it's a lot easier for me to be their guest than it is for any of them to be my guest. Especially considering how little notice I tend to have when I broadcast. I wasn't even sure I was going to be able to broadcast today because I was kind of figuring since the text for Salt and Sanctuary is going to be final in less than a week, I was torn between broadcasting today or trying to make some more progress on that, so... Kaito, you got your waifu body pillow. Which waifu? I guess I better comfort her. I think we might have a closet tsundere here. Oh, hidden porpoise. Plague has no interest in this. The randompers, I'm glad too, because I get to see all of you. It just means I'm going to have to stay up extra late to try and make a little bit more progress. Sparrowshade, welcome! Okay, but a body pillow of Fridge-chan? Really? I see, Kaito. I wish I could say I'm familiar with that. But I trust that you're happy now that you have your waifu body pillow. Congratulations. Right, the artist. Tempting. Clint, I would love to see that. Ams the Great, the real question is, why are you playing Dark Souls 2? It's freaking hilarious, Yumi. Totally hilarious. Soul Reclaimer, welcome! Relayer, take care of yourself. Thank you for stopping in. Oh, Filey. Filey, and you wonder why everybody thinks you're cute. Don't give me that crap. You say you want a body pillow of chat. Then you wonder why everybody says you're cute. Alright. Rank 3. Only 7 more ranks of this stuff left to go. Can't wait.
Bye then.
Kuros' area, that was, at this point, really more just a joke than anything else about Dark Souls 2.
Welcome home, big bro!
Demon Protector, wait till we get to the actual Death Social Link. Finally, I think Tsuyokomi got you. Fantastic fivesome body pillow? I'm just gonna pretend I didn't read that. What do we got in the fridge? Nothing! Let's see. Yeah, we'll work on Nanako's social link, because that one actually is fun. Because much like Filey, which is totally canon now, Naoto is cute. Yes. Let's chill with Nana-chan. Yay, everybody's happy. Ovan, I'm not sure you're watching the right kind of anime for this. Did I say Naoto? I thought I said Nanako. I thought I said Nana-chan, actually. I'm tired, leave me alone. Oh, Zane, please tell me I didn't say Naruto. Please. Filey, you did that to yourself. You can't blame me for that. Oh, I wonder who that could be. Yes, Jumping Jack, Nanako is indeed a social link. Oh, hey, Dojima might actually show his face at home for a change. Yeah, Filey, you can always blame me. But everybody will not always believe you. In before we get another phone call from Dojima saying that he's gonna be late. Oh no, we're out of pickled daikon! Dad'll be disappointed. I have an idea. He'll live? Jesus. Guess what? We get to go to Juness!
Thank you!
Hey, Leica Sir, welcome! Thank you for joining us! Great to see you! Well, Bub Austin, it seems you can save yourself the trouble in this case, because now the Germans are blaming each other. Thanks, Filey. Aww. Well, that's that then. Right, Ovan, right. Darth Pyros, the thing is, Canada hasn't done anything that they could even remotely be blamed for a long time.
I'm back!
I think the last thing they did that was worthy of blame was burning down the White House. And, well, that was kind of complicated. Oh, look! There's a stranger on our couch. Oh, forgot. Look at this. Look at it. All he can think of is, what were you idiots doing out late at night? That seems to have been the convention up to now, the artist. Oh, for God's sake. Dojima, you dick. Now I'm gonna have to stand up for her. You know... What?! Are you serious?! Really? I don't have enough courage? What a load of crap. Nice going, Dojima. Ah! Yeah, take that, dumbass. You know, if you'd bothered trying to find this out at the beginning, this would not have happened. Yep, not enough balls. Sorry, Kurosu's area. Hang in there. Like, Nanako had the balls to call her dad stupid to his face, and I can't even tell him it's not her fault. What? What? Really? I've been eating those beef bowls, Vegetable Spy. It's just that courage is one of the hardest stats in this game to level up. Yeah, Future Kaze, courage is apparently the most important stat. I was with her! What's the big deal? Oh, now I'm being yelled at. Yeah! I decided to go back to my room. Yeah, Black Ops Legend, but I think the thing is, we can't tell Dojima, because he'd never believe us. Censoroso, welcome! No, the artist, I think we gave ourselves a timeout from Dojima. Yeah, Tsuyokomi, the table flip is real. If only, Vegetable Spy, if only. Well, Black Ops Legend, I've always thought the same thing. I've always thought that, you know, considering Dojima is so suspicious of us, what'd be the big deal with taking him to the TV, bringing him in? Oh, now you have to believe us, Dojima. Oh, look, maybe now you'll even get a persona out of the deal. Oh, look. Maybe now you'll stop impeding our investigation at every turn. But that would throw such a huge wrench into the plot it wouldn't be able to proceed. So they can't do that. Finally, that's fair. Kaito, that's also fair. Great. No way. I wouldn't touch that with a 10-meter cattle prod. Alright, let's see if there's any scary new items. Probably, Xenifer. Dojima's persona would just be a giant pair of handcuffs. I wonder how the fox at the shrine is doing. Good, no scary items. Alright. Well, I think I remember there being some bonus to studying in the library on a rainy day. So I'm gonna go give that a try because I believe status. Could have sworn I could view my attributes. Ovon 20, I sense a joke there, but I'm not familiar with it. I'm afraid that's gone over my head. Oh, here it is, switch info. I knew it was around here somewhere, so... My courage is rank 2 out of 5. No wonder I'm too much of a puss to do anything. Zenpak, I've heard the line before, but I don't know where it comes from. Oh, geez, Ovan, that's a little dark. Yeah, exactly, Mayo. Reliable courage turns out to be anything but. Well, that's probably good advice. Oh, I see, Inepicinium. Thank you. Not yet, Vegetable Spy. We rescued him last time, but he's apparently still recovering. Now, where is the blasted library? Right, Zenpak. I'll just walk around the school with a rose between my teeth. And everybody will fall in love with me. Ooh, what have we got here? Have you ever called a radio station and requested a song before? I like doing it because you can request video game music. No, you can't. They don't have video game music at radio stations. Ah, thank you, Brosif. This simplicity makes radio a richer form of media than television. You know what's a richer form of radio than media? A richer form of media than radio? YouTube and Twitch. Oh, he's making a crystal radio, so clearly I need to get some magical component from a shadow. Oh, okay, no, that's actually pretty reasonable. He needs some wire. You can't figure out how to break down a TV. Have you ever heard of a sledgehammer? Well, that's funny, Ninja OFV, because I can't wait to never hear Chie complain again once I bench her. Mayo. We've got a couple of artists in attendance, so you never know, fan art may turn up. Yeah, probably, Cincerosa. Oh, I doubt it, Cincerosa. I'll look around in the TV. I love how I'll just tell him flat out, yeah, I'll go inside the TV and look around for you. And he just, oh, okay, sure. Thanks, man. Yellow Dio Mike, that's how you break pretty damn near anything. Sledgehammers are so versatile. Bub Austin, I am going to be benching Yukiko as soon as I get Naoto. Okay, so second floor practice building. We'll check this bathroom. Oh, that's right! I'm growing stuff in the garden! I'm not familiar with this proverb, Phyli. Enlighten me. No problem, the artist. Thank you for stopping in. Have fun being somewhere. Okay, second floor. Illini, welcome! Oh, geez. There's a fat minister laughing in my ear. Let's see here. Nomenanza, thank you so much. Nomenanza, thank you for the $15 donation. Nomenanza says, well, hello there. Finally made it, although for 30 minutes only. Also, when's Kanji's hot-ass sauna time? Nomenanza, I hate to tell you this, but that was the previous stream. However, I will be re-uploading that VOD to YouTube, so you can catch it then. Nevertheless, Nomenanza, thank you for stopping in, even if it's only for a few minutes. I'm always glad to see you, and once again, I truly appreciate the donation. Thank you. Every little bit helps enable me to do this sort of thing more often. Barring, of course, some kind of crunch time when I have to finish the text for Salt and Sanctuary, but that's the exception rather than the rule. RPG Nerd, welcome! Great to see you! Oh, Illini, yeah, I need to find a way of extracting those voices from the game. Clint, is that a good thing? Is it a good thing if you're a peach? Ovan, I could probably sentence mix, what's his name, Willem, saying that. Hollow Process, hey, welcome! Everyone's here. Gimpy, and Dumpy, and Lebelus, and... I need to be finding the library now. I can't keep doing this. Really, Tsuyokomi? Second floor? The library? Really? Let's see... Class... Class... Guess it's second floor practice building. I should have read that a little more carefully. Art room. Thank you, Illini. I appreciate that. Art room, biolab. Oh, a quest. Has anybody decided to give me a plastic model? No? Dad! I passed it, damn. Other end. Okay, thank you, Brosif. Well, I found a quest, so it all works out. Her dad suddenly started making plastic models. He got glue all over her desk. And she needs a fitting board to fix her desk. I'm sure I can find all kinds of random crap lying around in the TV dimension. Tsuyokomi, the thing is, can you extract it cleanly, as in, without the background music from the Velvet Room? Oh dear, this poor girl. Oh, Mr. Talos, why? Why? English classroom, workshop, sociology classroom. Okay, I guess I did pass it. Bob Austin, as far as I know, they haven't announced anything yet, so you're not going to find it. Yeah, Eleni, I agree. But you also have to remember that Elizabeth's voice actress is Tara Platt, who is Yuri Lowenthal's wife. She also plays Mitsuru, and she's fairly proliferate in other video games as well. So she's no stranger to voice acting, and yeah, she's pretty decent. There it is, the library. Thank you, Brosifs. So, Eleni, yeah, that's what's going on. Margaret is voiced by somebody else entirely. I can study here efficiently. Spend time at the library. Yes, I think I will. Ah, it's so nice and peaceful in this library. I was able to solve a difficult problem. Hooray for knowledge. Tank. Ah, that's great. That's great. Jeez, all these knowledge bonuses. But no increase, of course. Yeah, Vegetable Spy, that was great.
Welcome back.
Let's see. Yeah, Yellow Dio Mike. The way the Moonlight Greatsword works in Demon's Souls is that if somebody tries to block it with a shield, it will just go completely through the shield and not interact with it at all. It won't deflect. It won't cost any extra stamina for being blocked. It'll just pass directly through the person blocking, and it will do the full amount of damage. Eleni, I kind of feel like that's the last thing we need.
Hey!
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to hang out with Dickwad Dojima. Katamae, welcome! Yeah, I'm bored. I want to tell you what a dick you are. For being a dick to Nanako. Well, no social link rank up, but that's fine. We got the points. Okay. Yeah, Filey, that may well be. Personally, though, Filey, there's another adage I like a little bit better. Let me see if I can get Romanji input here to work. I like that one a little better. All right, so I think. Yeah, Clint, that's the motto of Nobunaga Oda. And it's pronounced Tenka Fubu, and it means spread militarism under the sun. Illini, yes, I would definitely use one of those, a teacup emote. Right, so I think I'm gonna save now and. We desperately need some courage. This cannot continue this way. So we're gonna go into town. Yeah, Central Shopping District. Don't you think that once something's written down in a book, it suddenly becomes more meaningful? No. Even I'm currently practicing something I read in a book a while ago. I'll remember that in Epicinium. Zane, no, your character's got a preset model in this game. Yes, you do, Ovan. It's one of the few things that you retain into New Game Plus. Bruce, if it's no problem. I imagine it can probably be extracted from the game data, and if worse comes to worst, I'll just put Hellkite Drake on that. Finally, I'm gonna say it again. You're doing this to yourself. I love how I had to accept the request before I knew what the request was. All right, Clint, take care. Thanks for stopping in. Give James and Michelle hugs for me. Oh, right, Bob Austin, we never did figure out what state you're in, did we? If it's spicy, I'm gonna take that as Cajun, so Louisiana? Illini, I believe in New Game Plus you retain your character level, your persona compendium, and pretty much everything associated with the Velvet Room. And your character attributes like courage and strength and all of that stuff. Yeah, the random Purs, he's the one who gave me the fat minister laugh. He extracted that stuff from Demon Souls for me originally, so. Thank you, Clint. Actually, I do feel obligated to bring up to chat that if anybody here is good at programming chatbots, Filey had a good idea the other day, which was that we should have a chatbot dedicated to keeping a running tally of slow claps. And the chatbot should have a hidden leaderboard that should be accessible via a chat command. Okay, this guy wants to feed a stray cat. All the books say you shouldn't feed feral animals, and they're right. Oh, why don't I risk my neck, get my face clawed off to do it for you? What a great idea. No problem, Shiloof, go study. I do truly want you to pass your psychology exam, even if you'll never get a job in psychology. Sure, I'll do it. Just like everybody else, Demon Protector. Well, Lennox, no, but it often sadly ends up being the other way around. Cats are extremely popular pets in Japan, but often in Japan people will move to an apartment that either doesn't allow cats or they'll end up otherwise in a living situation where they can't keep their cat. So they'll just abandon their cat and let it go, and in that way a house cat will become a stray and or feral animal. Take care, Shiloof. Dopest Sophist, I love that username. Welcome, I'm glad you could make it as well. Thank you. Thank you for stopping in. SubmNFL, I'm playing this on the Vita TV, or I guess it's called the PlayStation TV. I can never remember. Filey, I don't know if that counts. Although, in Epicinium, you're probably right. Even if she doesn't cheat, she'll still probably remain number one. Yeah, Deride, I've tried messing around with custom chatbots, too. They blew up in my face every time. Alright. Oh, cats eat fish! I can't even just go to the Shiroku store and buy some regular cat food. I have to catch him fish? Well, let's check to see if there are any new books then, because it sounds like, whoops, no, Forever Macho, 100 Ghost Stories, Catching Bugs. No, I guess I have everything already. Filey, that's not fair. Flairmew, good night, thank you so much for joining us. Right, of course, fish eat cats. That's how it works. Rare materials may be found. Peachy, peachy, chop. This is the sort of thing that translates very poorly from Japanese to any other language. Oh, look! I'm standing in front of the weapon shop singing about rare materials dropping on rainy days. Not a hint at all. Oh, look, another hint. Okay, I have a cheap knockoff of a more popular brand. Say goodbye to your foes. Okay. Lennox, it's onomatopoeia. They're... Japanese is one of those languages that they use words for sounds and sounds for words, if that makes sense. It's difficult to explain because the concept doesn't exist in every language, especially not in the West. Well, yes, Yellow Dio Mike. Oh, that's right! 20% off on rainy days! I forgot! I should have come here to do my shopping on a rainy day. Well, too late now. Yeah. Damn. Well, Illini, the only reason 20 mods showed up to my first stream was because it was my first stream. And because most of the members of the Souls community who broadcast on Twitch are mods on my channel because I know most of them. And the majority of them happened to show up for that first broadcast. Guess I better stock up on tap. Dopus Sophist. I think that really depends. There is sort of a very loose, vague, overarching timeline that kind of ties all of the Megami Tensei and Shin Megami Tensei and Persona games together. They're not all directly related, but a lot of them take place in the same or similar or sort of branching universes. So, in general, I would say that the earlier you start, the better. But the problem can be that some of Atlas's earlier games, because they were for older systems, can be a little bit more difficult to get into now if you're used to more modern gameplay and graphics. So, if you like retro games and you're not bothered by games that look a little bit older and more dated, I would say just go back and see if you can find Megami Ibunroku Persona. Unfortunately, the game disc goes for something like $300 on Amazon and eBay, so... Well, and that's the other piece of it, Illini. Pretty nearly all of the other broadcasters from the Souls community are experienced themselves on Twitch. I mean, you're talking guys like Peeve, Brandon, Ty, Jerp, Nelson, and you know, those guys, Lobos. So, yeah, they'll all know what they're doing. And the mods from their channels will know what they're doing. Which is why guys like Morrill and Jackety were mods from the very beginning on my channel, because they've been Peeves mods for a long time, and I know them, I know they're familiar with the responsibilities, and they know what to do, and that they're pretty much experts, so that's why there were so many mods that first time. Yellow Dio Mike, yes, one of my long-term goals has been to move to Japan to study the language. I've wanted to study it formally for a long, long time, but I just haven't been able to afford to, unfortunately. And I've been too busy with my day job to be able to really make that work. That's one of the other reasons that I want to make YouTube and Twitch a full-time thing. Because if I have a job that I can do from anywhere, then I can continue to support myself in Japan while studying the language. Bob Austin, there are PSP remakes of some of the earlier Atlas games, but they were changed a lot. A lot was cut from them, especially from the remake of Persona 2. Well, Innocent Sin and Eternal Punishment, rather. Triumphing Glory, welcome! No, Filey, you got modded because you and I knew each other before Twitch. Yes, Dr. PJ Salt. You say that, Filey, but now you're pretty much stuck here. Boots Daily, unfortunately no, it seems the contract for that guide ended up going to Prima. Which saddens me, but I can't say that I'm terribly surprised by it. Because Prima has tons and tons of fuck you dollars to throw at guarantees for guide contracts. And given that Bandai Namco is a gigantic company that loves money, I'm not the least bit surprised that they would probably accept a guarantee of something like $1 million from Prima for the contract of the guide. There's really not much way that a tiny company like Future Press can compete with that. Ovon 20, isn't it kind of sad to think of it that way? That, yeah, I have probably more money than Dojima. Oh, Bruticon, don't get in trouble for watching Twitch at work. I don't want you to lose your job on my account. For dollars, Filey. Interesting. I'm pretty sure I said Boots Bailey, didn't I, Boots Bailey? B's and D's sound kind of similar. Yeah, Bob Austin, I'm pretty sad about it too. I really would have loved to work on that game, but... Vegetable Spy, I like it too. I can't take any credit for coming up with it. That was Frank and Jorg. But, yeah. Oh, it's out of drinks, right. Well, Illini, unfortunately, you get that with pretty nearly every big Twitch broadcaster. I really think that both I and all of you are kind of spoiled to be able to have a chat like mine where the toxicity is really pretty much as close to zero as it could get. I don't think I've had to ban a single person in the entire time I've been broadcasting, which granted hasn't been that long, and I don't tend to get more than 100 to 200 people showing up at most. So, you know, the toxic element doesn't really tend to find their way here, and they don't tend to stay even if they do. But in bigger chats like Brandon's and Peeves and Lobos, pretty nearly everybody who's really well known, there's always that toxic element. And I mean, when I did the Demon's Souls stream with Wooly and Pat and Matt and Liam, we got up to something like 12,000 people at one point during that stream, and 12,000 people is a lot. Like, they were, I think, ranked 7th on all of Twitch for viewership, and the only reason they weren't ranked higher was because somebody else was playing Killer Instinct and had 20,000. Well, Peeves is a little bit more benign, and Barnesis is one of the best out of all of Solbrant, because he's one of the people that, he's a lot like me, I think, where he places so much focus on viewer interaction that he gets sidetracked from playing the games a lot, and I love him for that. I truly adore Barnesis for that, and I've had the privilege of being able to meet him in person and can personally vouch for the fact that he's the sort of guy where you talk to him for 5 minutes and you just want to hug him. Like, he's that nice. But You know, there's always some element on bigger chats of some level of cancer and toxicity. Correct, Doride. Yes, I will be playing Dark Souls 3 blind, and that will be the first playthrough that I upload to YouTube. Well, Illini, I don't know if it's so much a question of scaring away toxicity, so much as this is just the sort of environment that toxic people can't stand. An environment of love and respect and acceptance. And I think toxic people tend to congregate in places where other toxic people hang out. And since no toxic people hang out here, it's sort of a deterrent for toxic people to try and come in here and worm their way in. So you sort of have a self-perpetuating process where the lack of toxicity deters any further toxicity. Boots Bailey, I will tell you that Dark Souls 2 is going to be a very different experience if you've played all of the other ones, but not that game. Well, Mayo, that's my feeling as well. I don't know what I would do if I got upwards of 1,000 people here. Which I probably never will, so it's fine. I can't remember if I actually saved, so I'm gonna just play it safe. Because what I need here... what I need here is an increase in courage. A country with no toxicity. I wish, Ovan, I wish. The Dirty Colossus, you know... I get people telling me that constantly. But as much as I understand the value of that first blind experience, I don't personally really value it all that much. I mean, yes, it's nice, but now that I've learned what it's like to be able to see behind the scenes on something as personally interesting to me as a Souls game, I would readily trade that first blind experience for being able to work on a guide. And I know a lot of people don't feel that same way, but for me personally, I enjoy that experience even more than I do the first blind playthrough. Yeah, just a bit out of control, didn't it, Eviscerator? Yeah, Nominanza, there's not enough blooming purple moss for the level of toxicity that some chats get. Did I say Cincerosa? I meant Nominanza. I'm sorry. Although, I guess Cincerosa, for your comment, that fits too. System of a Down. I don't know Vegetable Spy, but... I think maybe some book does raise your courage, but I want the increase from the Super Meat Bowl. Because that gives you a bunch of other things as well. And I think I could use some understanding as well, so... Oh! Geez, Yellow Dio Mike, thank you. Alright. So, we're gonna go for courage and understanding, and if I don't get level ups in both of those... Hollow Process, I'd like to write guides for games that are actually good, though. Akali Thompson, welcome! Glad to have you. Well, the Random Press, that's the thing. So few people have worked on official strategy guides that it's perfectly understandable nobody can really empathize with me on this. And I mean, I don't expect anybody to, but... it just, you know, I'm just putting my feelings out there on the table. Well, Illini, the broadcaster himself, or herself, is also a very significant factor in the level of toxicity in their chat, because, I mean... Cinsa Rosa. Yeah, Cinsa Rosa, I know exactly what you're talking about. Filey, you're just looking for an opportunity to ban somebody. I know it. I know you. Triumphant Glory, just hit the T command. It's active again today. And yeah, the broadcaster really does largely determine the chat. Because if it's a broadcaster, I mean, you take a guy like PewDiePie. You guys all know what PewDiePie's fans tend to be like, right? Well, there's a certain kind of person that he attracts to him. And there's a certain kind of person that I tend to attract to me, or at least that I try to attract to me. And that really is a large factor in determining the caliber of one's Twitch chat and YouTube comment sections and just viewer base in general. Well, Illini, I try. Knowledge, courage, diligence. Damn it. Gonna need that understanding. And Illini, I actually...
And now, the weather.
I try my best, Illini, to not only attract people who are the civil and kind and accepting sort, but I try to make it clear to the people who are not that I don't really want them around, you know? If somebody shows up and is the kind of person who is just starting fights in chat or in the comments section and just being a dick to everybody and spamming dirty comments without any real context just for the sake of being dirty, rather than actually tying them to whatever is being discussed in chat, then, yeah, I'm perfectly happy to say, look, you know, you are probably better served going somewhere else. I'm not particularly fond of that sort of company. Oh, Illini, yeah. Yeah. Thank you for at least adding a kappa there. Because otherwise I would have felt obligated. Skellagroove, welcome! Great to see you. Well, no, I'm talking about a very specific kind of dirty comments. The way that chat here behaves, that's fine. Because stuff comes up in discussion. And hell, stuff comes up in the game. All that stuff about polishing balls, you know? Persona 4 literally shoved the balls right in our faces. What are we supposed to do? But that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the guy who shows up and just says penis, fart, poop all the time and says nothing else and says it out of context and says it because he thinks he's impressing somebody by being raunchy. That's a very specific kind of dirty that's like the 10-year-old level dirty. Which I don't really care for. There's a difference between that and the adult level of dirty, where, yes, adults may use those same words, but they'll use them in a particular context, or they'll use them to make a joke that's clever, and that we can all laugh at, because we're mature enough not to just sit there repeating those words for hours. Exactly, Mayo. That's kind of the difference. So... Oh, dear. Well, okay, Filey, or maybe some not-so-clever jokes, but that's why I keep you around, isn't it? Well, one of the reasons. Also, so that maybe someday you'll have your opportunity to ban somebody who shows up in chat and just makes frivolously dirty comments out of context. Cinsarosa, I think that... Hey, it's Dropout! Hey, Dropout, welcome! Always glad to see you there, buddy. So, Dropout, I think what I'm going to do... I'm going to give you a call after February 8th. Because at that point, I won't have to worry about finishing up the text for Salt and Sanctuary. Because the text will be final by then. And I won't feel obligated to spend all my free time not used to support myself working on the Salt and Sanctuary text. Yes, Katamaya, that's a slow clap. Katamaya, you've never heard a slow clap? Zane, that was a reference to Dark Souls. Because dung pies are an item that inflict toxin. Understanding, knowledge, and courage. Fantastic! Just what I wanted. In the meantime, Dropout, how have you been? We don't seem to cross paths other than when you show up when I'm streaming in an attempt to not starve. Aww. Aya's daughter is in love with me, just like everyone else. Akali Thompson, it's fine. Really, I'm just happy to have you guys here.
And now, the weather. The week ended on a wet note as rain clouds moved into the area.
And honestly, Akali Thompson, I say this every stream, but what really makes this even more rewarding for me than the donations is just the company. Because, I mean, it's as we've said before, this is one of the few places on Twitch where there's virtually zero toxicity. And I'm really proud of that, and I enjoy being here as much as a lot of you seem to, so... Oh god, Illini, I don't know about that. Yeah, Dropout, it is, isn't it? Always. Oh, okay. Well, I hope your internet stabilizes, Dropout. Illini, Aya's daughter has blue hair and she just wears a regular student uniform. In Epicinium, I'm saving up. Believe me, I'm saving up. Just to study in Japan for a year is really, really expensive. And that only usually covers tuition. You're still on your own as far as food and all the other stuff is concerned. And lodging, often.
As a result, a thick fog is expected to form in the Inaba region later tonight.
Oh yeah, Nomenanza, she's awesome in the anime. She's this badass motor scooter driving kind of flat affect, emotionless. Yeah, she's cool. Doride, what? How? Why? What? Where are you coming up with that all of a sudden? Aren't I always the one telling kids to use protection? You know, because you've always got to strap on a Magnum if you want a little bit of extra protection. Oh, Mayo, I appreciate that. I would be flattered even if you said full homo. I wouldn't be able to help you, but I would still be flattered. You know, Yellow Dio Mike, I've always thought it would be fun to open my own tea shop. And just have video games. Like, you know the internet cafes that exist in some countries? Where you can go in and play video games and stuff, except just tea. And Dark Souls. Darth Pyros, I find those sorts of references are always a little bit more amusing if you're only half paying attention when somebody makes them. Thank you, Filey, thank you. I'm glad I'm now the, what, second, third person to earn a slow clap? This stream? I guess, Abyss Raider, I've never actually heard of a video game bar. Where do those exist? Holo Process, that's gonna be a huge cup of tea. You know what? I wonder if I can... Oh, damn it, I need to watch the Midnight Channel. Oh, so Canada, Abyss Raider, okay. Oh, that's right, Bob Austin. I keep forgetting. Well, arcade bars, barcades, right. I guess I wasn't really thinking of that. For some reason, I was thinking of a bar with an internet cafe rather than just arcades, like arcade cabinets. Because that was sort of the context in which it seemed to have come up in chat, and I'm not good at lateral thinking. Oh, no kidding, Filey. Holo Process, they do make little plastic swords. You do sometimes see them in drinks. Okay, well, I guess we have to watch the Midnight Channel. Skellagroove, Dark Souls would be a spicy tea. Something that just burns your throat, but is so delicious you can't stop drinking it. Filey and I were talking about this the other day, actually. About, I think it was Urban Orb, who made that video about how Dark Souls is like... The tsundere girlfriend, who, she kicks you in the balls all the time, but you just keep coming back to her because you love her so much and you can't get enough. McCool, hey, welcome! Yes, Illini, I need that too. yeah, that Greedo, maybe it is. Sorry, Mayo. Sorry to hear that. Thank you, Filey. Right on the ball with those links. Human Giant, you're not playing Vandal Hearts 2, are you? Yeah, we stuck it to that dumbass killer. Yeah, Skellagroove, Dark Souls has ruined a lot of other games for me as well in that way. No problem, Darth Pyros. Don't neglect the girl. You don't want to do that. Meanwhile, at the fog-shrouded shopping district... Again! Oh, no. Oh, I see, Human Giant. In Epicenium, Tsundere is the one where she alternates between acting like she doesn't like you and then acting all sad that you're mad at her. Yellow Dio Mike, I've never really spent too much time playing the Kingsfield games. Illini, you don't actually pronounce the ellipsis. You just stay silent for a few seconds. Oh, hey! Maybe I should watch the home shopping program. Oh, Moriel, no problem. I don't want to keep you from work. So thank you so much for stopping in. Good luck at work, Moral. Yeah, I see in Epicenium. Lindsay! Welcome to you, Lindsay. No problem, Nominanza. Take care of yourself. Thank you so much for stopping in. To everybody asking what this song is... God, I know, Moral, I know. Once I'm finished with the Salt and Sanctuary text, I'll be able to stream more often. But yeah, to everybody asking about this song, this is a carryover from Persona 3, as is this character, President Tanaka. He's actually a social link in Persona 3. He's the sort of... like, evil, greedy, corrupt corporation head who scams everybody. Yes, Mayo, this is a P3 song. The shopping channel like this exists exactly in the same way in Persona 3. You can still buy stuff from it on, I think, Sundays or weekends or whatever, because it's a nationally broadcast program. Great! More fundoshi! A fundoshi is basically the jock strap that sumo wrestlers wear. So, when he says tie it tight to boost your vitality... No, I don't think so. Oh my goodness, I can't believe its wonderfulness! And he'll even give me a slimming food so that my fundoshi can fall down and expose my balls on stream in front of everyone. Yellow Dio Mike, he's basically more of a bumbling, cheerful Albert Wesker, yes. The Steam sales. Yeah, Zero Troy. Ooh, an Inaba Trout. Oh, he wants to sell me some fish. Ah, damn. This is tough. Well, I imagine I can get the fish anytime, so I'm going to get the fundoshi. Presumably Sincerosa, yes, I should hope so. Oh god, Eviscerator. Eviscerator, if it makes you feel any better about the fundoshi, I am actually sitting here in nothing but my bathrobe because it's been a long day at work. So while a bathrobe is not quite a fundoshi, I am well at the point of being ready to relax for the evening, so... Well, no, Holoprocess. He was offering either jock straps or fish. Oh, and diet food. Yeah, sorry, Ninja OFV. I've gotta advance past this so that people don't have to listen to this terrible song. Well, no, Eviscerator, because a bathrobe covers your entire body. Hey, it's the Dark Fallout! Hi, Dark Fallout. Well, see, Eviscerator, that's the beauty of broadcasting without face cam. You never know what I'm wearing. I might be sitting here completely naked for all you know. Exactly, dopest sophist. I mean, think about it. The image of a sumo wrestler just carrying a giant fish, like a big old frozen tuna, the way that they often portray as weapons, as joke weapons in Japanese games. Good night, Sincerosa. Thank you so much for stopping in. Take care of yourself. Oh no, Holoprocess. Believe me, I tie my bathrobe. I haven't had any girls over in a while, so there's no reason for me... I'll stop now. Mayo, I... You have just spawned some terrible fan art. Mitch TX, welcome! I believe I didn't say promises, just the tease of the possibility. Akali Thompson, if there are lewd images in your head, they were probably there long before I opened my mouth. Zero Troy, I'm not even kidding about that being a common joke weapon in Japanese games. Linsei, would you do me a favor, please, and post the fan art you drew of Bonfire-chan from that Zaibatsu stream? That was fantastic. No, Mayo, no. Suyokomi, why? Why are you salty? What's going on? Talk to me. Crimson Helm, I swear it's not what it sounds like. What, Priscilla Body Pillow Eviscerator? How dare you imply... You know what, Yellow Deal Mike, after seeing Wooly's Street Fighter Snuggie on camera last weekend, I would throw down for a Dark Souls Snuggie. Hell, I would buy a Snuggie with Igor on it. Lindsay, Matt thought that was a good picture, okay? Shut up about it being terrible. No, Deride, that would be Lindsay. Please. Oh, in Epicinium, nice. Lindsay, see? The Dark Fallout, you're not even kidding. Ask Plague about that, he'll tell you. He hates everything he does. Isn't a body pillow of Bonfire Chan just a bonfire? Like, you throw yourself into it. Oh, fantastic, Tsuyokomi. Thank you. Right, I'll pass, thank you. As generous as that is. Okay, well, I better go do stuff now. Aw, holo process. Nice, Filey. Alright. So, speaking of fish, I think maybe. Hey, she got seedlings. Crack wheat. Crack wheat. Legends of bandits using this stuff to open locks. Piranha cabbage. Oh, damn it, Tsuyokomi. I see. Thank you. Well, I guess we'd better buy everything. We'll buy the seedling, and we'll buy the seedling. And she's out of everything, so... Oh, I can harvest them in one more days. Excellent. Just as soon as I get more black lamp. Is there nothing I can do to feed this poor dog? Tomatoes and daikon sautéed with oysters. I don't think that's a good idea. All right. I just barely caught a cracked up comment in chat. Whoever that was deserves a slow clap. Filey, please get on that. Selling crack and juicing up. Filey, I think you need a slow clap too. You know what? Yeah, Ibis Raider, that's the Hiranya item. Oh, sorry to hear that, Filey. Waste of good tea, eh? Ah, yes, Plague's rendition of Bonfire Chan. Okay. So, we need to pick ourselves up a fishing rod. Leaves smelling the roses when you get to my age. Okay, Don't worry, mister. I'll leave pushing up the daisies till I get... Oh, sorry. That's terrible. You've got a problem? Well, maybe I've got a solution. I brought my rod, but there's no hook. Can I spare a fish hook? I do have a fish hook. Oh, that's right, Filey. I'm sorry to hear that. Akali Thompson, what are you talking about? You're always allowed here. But dude, this is your fishing rod. Ah, okay, so he's passing on his old rod to me. Thank you! Okay. Jerp! Hey, Jerp! Great to see you, man. How's it going? Well, Twitch notifications don't really seem to work very well anyway. Zero Troy, that kind of hook is really good for catching big fish. Take care, Iron Paws. Thank you for joining us. Alright, I guess I'd better learn about fishing. Because I don't remember this from P4. That little natural pier jutting out. That's not a natural pier, that's concrete. But okay. Used to go sea fishing. Oh. Okay, so... You gotta bait the hook, then you cast it out into the water. When the bobber sinks, that's when you start reeling her in. You gotta remember not to put too much stress on the line. Easy, right? The rest is all about diligence, okay? So you need diligence for fishing. Yeah, Drip, I've been doing okay. I'm embarrassed to admit this, Drip, but I've actually been lurking in your streams a little bit. I stopped in for Mega Man 10 and some of the other stuff you were doing around that time. And it seems you're doing well as well. I hope that's continuing to be the case. How go your experiments with bread? I see that you've been... on Twitter, you've been making your own? Well, no, Akali Thompson, what I mean is, I don't remember fishing from P4 Vanilla. We're playing Persona 4 Golden here. And I don't remember if there even was fishing in Persona 4 Vanilla. Oh, Filey. Oh, jeez, Jerp, I'm sorry to hear that. Nothing is sacred in today's economy, is it? Bugsire, welcome! Yeah, Mitch TX, I guess I must not have done too much of it. Yeah, Zane, the Soramini of any of the lyrics of Persona music tends to be pretty amusing. And I guess I should explain soramimi. It's a Japanese term that means from the air to the ear, which is just basically you interpret it as you hear it rather than what the lyrics actually are. Because let's face it, J-pop lyrics in English tend to be pretty indistinguishable. Oh, okay, Jerp. Oh, I see. Yeah, it sucks when stuff's mismanaged. And then they panic and downsize. I'm sorry, man. But at least you'll have some opportunity to work on your bread. And on growing Twitch. I'll refer people to you as often as I can, Jerp, because one of the things you've got going for you that not too many people on Twitch have is that you're well-spoken and very knowledgeable. And it's a shame more people don't know about you. Yes, Doride, like taking some pounding. So Yokomi, what do you mean? Which format? Are we talking WAV or MP3? Preferably uncompressed, so whatever the original format is. Yeah, Illini, there's a word for that, where they mix English lyrics with Japanese lyrics. I forget the word. So I see, Filey. Honestly, Jerp, your personality alone sets you apart. I like that about you, how you've got that sort of well-spoken, but sort of dry and sardonic way about you that I really like. And I think, honestly, Jerp, have you tried playing Darkest Dungeon? Because I have a feeling you'd probably like that game, and I think your personality is quite well suited to it. Especially considering you got your start playing Souls, because those games are really fantastic for giving you the sort of exhilaration the Souls games once did before I played them for 4,000 hours each. Hey, Russo Hayden! Yeah, seriously, to anybody in chat who is not already familiar with my friend here, Jerp, you should go check him out. Because he doesn't get anywhere near enough attention. And he's a very unique personality on Twitch, and on YouTube even. Oh, yeah, That's what that game does, Jerp. It builds you up, it gets you attached to your favorite characters, and then it kills them and makes you sad. This old man is dancing around the point that rainy days are better for fishing. All right. Great. So we got the fishing rod. Filey, I knew you would like that. Yeah, Jerp, I've always appreciated the amount of effort that goes into what seems simple, setting up some overlays and things like that. I really liked what you did with Mega Man 10, how you had yourself green screened and then the cover art of Mega Man 10 on the green screen. That was really clever. Oh, and another thing, actually, to any of my viewers who are fans of Bitterbits because of Nick's expertise with audio and programming, that sort of thing. Jerp is another one who's very, very well versed in that. So, he's one who can probably really help if you're looking for advice on how to optimize your computer setup. Oh, is the stream going nuts again, Skelegroove? Oh, no, I see what you mean, because 2 hours, right.